Welcome all for another video, Dr. RS and you, on science of cosmetics and personal care products. We are in part 31 and we are going to discuss on building blocks actives. It's code I, now skin pigmentation, section I on skin pigmentation, right? So it's skin pigmentation. So now part 7, right? Part 7, we discussed skin pigmentation in detail, right? So please go to part 7, read part 7 first, listen to that video before going to the actives for skin pigmentation. So there I have given synthesis. We are going into the next higher level. I'm putting synthetic root of melanin little more deeper so that you will understand the actives better. So I trust you have gone to that presentation before coming to this. No, so skin pigmentation. No, I. So this is part 31, right? Part 31. So it's a skin pigmentation. So part 31, skin pigmentation, building blocks, actives, skin pigmentation actives, right? So skin pigmentation actives, that is part 31, skin pigmentation actives, right? Now, this we have seen. So this is the epidermis, this is the dermis, epidermis, and this is the dermis, at the junction of epidermis and dermis you have the specific cell called melanocytes, right? We saw that melanocytes, and these melanocytes produce melanosomes, and inside melanosomes melanin is present, right? This we discussed. Go to that the section part 7 again, right? Go through that slide. Then what happens? Melanocyte produces melanosome, and inside melanosome melanin is there. And each melanocyte put dendrites, and these are all the keratinocytes. These are all the keratinocytes, cyte cells. As soon as melanosomes are formed, the melanosomes are transferred from melanocyte to keratinocytes. No, each melanocyte can put dendrites in such a way that it can transfer to 30 to 40 keratinocytes, right? So it put dendrites and it transfer melanosomes. This is melanocyte. It produces melanosome and transfer. These are all melanosomes. It transfer melanosomes, right? So melanocytes produce melanosomes, and inside melanosomes melanin is there, pigment melanin is there, right? So melanocyte, human beings have approximately same number of melanocytes regardless of skin color. There are no melanocytes in the palmar and the sole. Melanosomes produced in melanocyte contain granules melanin. Melanosomes are transferred to keratinocytes, right? This is the this is how pigmentation happens, especially the sunlight trigger or other factors. The melanosomes are transferred and comes out. So I've discussed this in detail in part 7. You can go to part 7 and look into that. I'm not going to discuss it here in detail. I'm going to spend some time on actives. Now, what happens? These are all the melanosomes. This is the melanocyte producing melanosomes. Melanosomes are transferred from melanocyte to keratinocytes. So you know that the skin cells are dynamic, right? Old cells come out, new cells are formed, right? It's a dynamic, right? The cells move up. Okay. When the melanin is synthesis, there are two type of polymer synthesis synthesized. We studied this in part 7, pheomelanin and eumelanin. Again, I'm telling you, go to part 7. I have explained it fully. Pheomelanin and eumelanin. Pheomelanin is in fair skin people. Eumelanin in black skin people. Black color skin people. This is fair colored skin people. Black colored skin people. Right. So, what happens? Here, pheomelanin is, even when it reaches the outer layer, it gets decomposed and the color is lost. But, eumelanin, it's very strong. Eumelanin is strong. Even when it reaches the outermost layer, it is still there. So, combination of various ratios of eumelanin and pheomelanin gives the skin color, gives the hair color, all these things. Now, we discussed in sunscreens also the Fitzpatrick scale and how some skin can get tanned more. And how some skin can get burnt more. All those aspects I'm not going to explain here. But this is what. There are two types of melanin. Pheomelanin and eumelanin. Again I'm saying go to part 7. And then read that fully before. I'm not going to explain here. See now. This is synthesis of melanin. Right. So, tyrosinase, L-tyrosine, it's the amino acid. In the presence of tyrosinase enzyme, it converts into L-DOPA. Again, tyrosinase enzyme, dopaquine. And it complexes with L-cysteine, cysteine-DOPA. And then it polymerizes pheomelanin. Okay, this is pheomelanin. This is in fair skin people, fair colored skin people. Right, pheomelanin. Right. So there can be the other route. No, this dopaquine get converted into L-cyclodopa, right? And then dopachrome, dihydroxyindole. This is di, this is the indole molecule. This is called DHI. I have written here. DHI, right here. Dihydroxyindole. Right, and then again tyrosinase, this is indole 5-6 quinone, these are 5-6 position, this is indole 5,6-phenone. Last time I gave a simpler step, this time I am giving a little more. So this is getting converted into, polymerized into eumelanin, right? Then dihydroxyindole also can get converted into eumelanin. That is, from L-dopa chrome, the L-dopa chrome, it can get converted into dihydroxyindole carboxylic acid. Okay, with tyrosinase, it is indole quinone carboxylic acid. Indole quinone carboxylic acid. This is indole 5,6-quinone. That's it. Since this carboxylic acid ring is there, it is indole quinone carboxylic acid. Then it converts into eumelanin. So this eumelanin is in black colored skin people. So this is very stable. This color, not stable color. We discussed in section 7 how the fair colored skin people, they get lot of blemishes, they have lot of skin problems because they are not protected from UV, ultraviolet rays. But black skin people, they are protected with from ultraviolet rays fully, because melanin is the one which protects the skin from ultraviolet rays, right? So this is the pathway of melanin synthesis. Lot of enzymes are involved, right? So this is how this is the synthetic pathway. Now we will keep it here so that we might require it again. So now, skin blemishes. What can be the skin blemishes? Age spots, right? Post inflammatory hyperpigmentation. Somewhere some inflammation happens, and that place you get hyperpigmentation, melasma, sun exposed area pigmentation. Age spot in aging, we discussed this, no? Where there can be excess production of melanin and then you get the age spots. Post inflammatory hyperpigmentation, melasma, sun exposed area, right? All those things are the major causes for skin blemishes that a product, skin lightening product, can address, right? Now, how to control the skin color? How to modulate the skin color? How to modulate? See, four stages. In a broad way, it can be divided into four stages. Biogenesis of melanosomes itself in melanocytes. Biogenesis of melanosomes in melanocyte. Biosynthesis of melanin precursors and polymerization of melanin in melanocytes. Most of the actives work in this part. Transfer of melanosomes to keratinocytes, whether if it blocks, right, the transfer of melanosomes. Right, we see the biogenesis of melanosome itself, inside melanocyte, block that. Then synthesis of melanin, block that. Transfer of melanosomes from melanocyte to keratinocyte, block this transfer. And then movement and degradation in keratinocytes. Degrade fast. How to degrade the melanin fast in the keratinocytes so that it will not show up as black color on the skin, right? So those are the those can be the four broad stages to manipulate or modulate skin color. What are the things? Biogenesis of melanocytes itself, biosynthesis of melanin, control the transfer of melanosomes to from melanocyte to keratinocytes, melanosome from melanocyte to keratinocyte, movement and degradation of keratinocytes, degradation of melanosomes. See, once the transfer happens to melanosomes, the transfer happens to keratinocytes, melanosomes are transferred to keratinocytes, right? Then how to degrade it faster? That is another area where the actives can work. Now, we will go to skin color modulation actives. Now, when we discuss actives, there are many pathways. In the initial, I was telling you that I am not going to discuss about actives that are used in prescription medicines. But here I am explaining because it's a very, very important field, skin blemishes. So, I am going to discuss actives that are used in pharmaceuticals also as of now. So, I will discuss all the actives now, right? So, in this pigmentation itself, excuse me, right? So, skin color modulation, I will tell the actives and its mechanism of action. 2,5 dihydroxybenzoic acid, it's a component of gentiana root. It inhibits melanin synthesis, right? It inhibits melanin synthesis. 2, all trans retinoic acid tretinoin, it increases the cell turnover. So what happens? The keratinocytes, which has melanosomes, the increased cell turnover brings those keratinocytes which has been with a lot of melanosomes out very fast, right? Alloresin and aloe vera component inhibits tyrosinase. Tyrosinase, we saw here in the synthesis, tyrosinase is an enzyme which catalyzes various steps. So, aloe resin and aloe vera component inhibits tyrosinase, some of the components. Alpha hydroxy acids, desquamation, right? Tretinoin, right? It increases the cell turnover rate and removes the keratinocytes that contain melanosomes very fast, right? Then arbutin and deoxyarbutin inhibits dihydroxyindole carboxylic acid polymerase activity, inhibits melanosome maturation, melanosome maturation. Here, dihydroxyindole carboxylic acid is there. So, this is the enzyme that converts dihydroxyindole carboxylic acid to eumelanins, right? So, arbutin works in this pathway. It restricts the conversion of DHICA to eumelanins, right? To eumelanins, right? And also also inhibits melanosome maturation. That's how. Azelaic acid is copper chelation. Copper ions are necessary to activate tyrosinase enzyme that catalyzes the synthesis. Tyrosinase catalyzes the synthesis of melanin. So copper, if you chelate copper, because copper ions are necessary for to activate tyrosinase. Okay, the mechanisms are very very complex, still studied, but copper chelation, azelaic acid works by copper chelation and reduce the activity of tyrosinase enzyme. Okay, C2 ceramides decrease MITF expression, microphthalmia associated transcription factor. Okay, this factor, if it is activated, this factor has a role to play in melanoma. Melanoma is overproduction of melanin, right? Get into the cancerous form of melanoma. So this C2 ceramide decrease MITF expression and therefore decrease the melanin synthesis, right? Ellagic acid and pomegranate extract inhibit tyrosinase activity, right? Hydroquinone, widely used in pharma products, tyrosinase inhibition, right? Jojoba extracts some of the actives, inhibits tyrosinase. So what the next thing is, kojic acid is very important. It's used in Japan in the skin lightening products. It inactivates tyrosinase by copper chelation, like what we saw in azelaic acid. So it inactivates tyrosinase by copper chelation and also suppress the conversion from DC to DHICA. What is this? DC is dopachrome. Okay, dopachrome is converted into dihydroxyindole carboxylic acid. No, it works on this step. Okay, in this step, and it interferes with the formation of dihydroxyindole carboxylic acid, right? So kojic acid inactivate tyrosinase by copper chelation. I told copper is necessary for it's necessary for tyrosinase activity. Copper ions, if chelated, copper ions will not be available. So tyrosinase will be deactivated. If tyrosinase is deactivated, melanin will not be produced. Same way, when dopachrome conversion to dihydroxyindole carboxylic acid step is also blocked. So in this way, it suppresses the melanin synthesis. So L-ascorbic acid, vitamin C and derivatives, interacts with copper ions at tyrosinase active site, reduce dopaquinone and blocks DHCA oxidation. Okay, DHCA oxidation, dihydroxyindole carboxylic acid oxidation, it produces indolequinone carboxylic acid, which forms eumelanin. So it reduces dopaquinone, blocks DHICA oxidation, right? So it interferes with the synthesis of melanin in various steps also. No, these are all, some of them are proved through the cell line studies. So, then licorice extract, licorice inhibit tyrosinase, lignin peroxide, an enzyme, it decomposes melanin. It decomposes melanin. Linoleic acid and alpha linoleic acid suppress melanin production. Lipoic acid reduce microphthalmia associated on tyrosinase inhibition. Right? The melanoma factor, if it is activated, right? Milk proteins, tyrosinase inhibition. Vitamin B3, niacinamide or vitamin B3 inhibits melanosome transfer. It inhibits melanosome transfer from melanocyte to keratinocyte. Widely used in cosmetics. Widely used in cosmetics. Right, this ingredient is widely used in cosmetics. We also saw this, this vitamin B3 has many functions. It inhibits the melanosome transfer. And in moisturization, we also saw that it can initiate the synthesis of ceramide lipids. Ceramide lipids hold moisture. It improves the ceramide lipids. Lot of dermal functions have been found. This niacinamide has lot of skin benefits, which has been. And this is a pellagra preventing factor, I told you before. Pellagra is a condition where vitamin B3, lack of vitamin B3, you get dark patches, your skin becomes susceptible to sunlight, right? So that is pellagra, and if you take vitamin B3, it cures you from pellagra, right? So from pepper, no, piper longuminin, from piper longum, down regulates tyrosinase expression via microphthalmia associated transcription factor MITF, the melanoma factor, no. Prothocyanidin, polyphenolic antioxidant in grape seed extract, inhibit tyrosinase. Resorcinol, desquamation, right? Resveratrol, component of red wine, reduce MITF and tyrosinase inhibitor. Salicylic acid, desquamation. Soyabean extract, inhibit PAR2, means protease activated receptor 2 cleavage. So, PAR2 this enzyme, it is supposed to transfer of melanosome from melanocyte to keratinocyte, from melanocyte to keratinocyte. Niacinamide, we saw that, no? PAR2 behaves in a similar way. If you suppress PAR2, that protease activated receptor 2, it reduces the transfer of melanosome from melanocyte to keratinocytes. Right? There are other pathways which has been explained biologically on the action of PAR2, but PAR2 actually act on the melanosome transfer. No? That is how inhibition of PAR2, PAR2, not PAR2, 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 so inhibits the melanosome transfer and thus produce skin lightening. Another two ingredients, tranexamic acid, 4-aminomethyl cyclohexane carboxylic acid. These two ingredients are also potent melanin synthesis. So these are the some of the ingredients that are used, evaluated for skin pigmentation. So these, some of them are used for blemish control. Most of them act by various routes, no? Routes. So most of these ingredients might not be same for safe for long-term use, right? We have to evaluate, right? A lot of studies have to be done for use in personal care products. That's why I'm telling you, there are a lot of things available, but to be that can be used for a particular condition. But if you come to cosmeceuticals or personal care products, the usage of certain ingredients are restricted, and that is the challenge, right? This is what I am telling you, right? So skin color modulation for synergistic benefits, these actives should be combined with sunscreens, both UVA and UVB protection, with more emphasis on UVA protection, because UVA protect from skin tanning, right? So with more of UVA protection, right? That, in that way you can modulate the skin color. So to summarize, right, I can take a special one session for that, but I want to just if for a glowing skin, no? So everything is important, cleansing, no? Is very, very important. If acne prone skin with mild keratolytes, then moisturizing the skin is important, right? So that cleansing, no, excess oil secretion make the face, or excess sebum secretion, we can put technical term, make the face look dull, right? So moisturizing is very, very important. Moisture balance of the skin should be maintained. Then protection from excessive exposure to sunlight, right? So adequate adequately protect skin with antioxidants, balanced diet, exercise, and positive attitude. Right. So ultimately it boils down to these areas where you have to take care, right? Very briefly, but it's a big science, no? You can do wonders in this field. So this is what I want to say about skin lightening actives. While ending, I used to have my life lessons. Part 31, the life lesson is, emotional stability is an important factor to spiritual evolution. That's what I want to tell you. Thank you for listening to me. Let us get connected in the next session. Till then, bye.